Hello, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome to PE Monroe Auditorium at Lenore Ryan University. Please take a moment to silence all electronic devices and take note of the exit nearest you. There are three exits to your left and your right. You may also exit through the lobby doors where you entered. Per North Carolina Fire Code, I would like to remind you that only staff members of PE Monroe Auditorium may stand or sit in the aisleways at any time during the performance. Thank you, and please enjoy this event. Hello, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome to PE Monroe Auditorium at Lenore Ryan University. Please take a moment to silence all electronic devices and take note of the exit nearest you. There are three exits to the left and three exits to the right. You may also exit to the lobby doors where you entered. I would like to remind you, per North Carolina Fire Code, only staff members of PE Monroe Auditorium may stand or sit in the aisleways at any time during this event. Please enjoy this event.
Thank you. I'll speak loudly. I would like to tell you a little bit about our first selection. It's by a North Carolinian, Andrew Blair. Andrew was the band director for a while at Maiden High School, so we've got a little bit of a local connection to him, and I do a little bit more because he's my son-in-law. So I hope you'll enjoy Anti-Fanfare.
We'll be right back. Don't worry, I'm not going to conduct. A little bit about the history of band at Lenoir Rhyne University. Instrumental music at Lenoir Rhyne has a long history beginning in the early 1900s and continues today. In the beginning, instrumental ensembles at LR were extracurricular and most often led by students or non-music faculty. Since the mid-20th century, instrumental music has been offered as official classes at LR. Lenoir Rhyne has had 5 tenured band directors during that time: Dr. Robin F. Gatwood, Dr. Ralph Gabriel, Dr. Joseph Seacrest, Mr. Robert Fleming, and Dr. Daniel W. Kaiser. The leadership of these talented musicians and conductors has served to advance the LR band program throughout the years. Instrumental music at LR began with the formation of the Oakview Orchestra during the 1907-08 school year. This orchestra stayed busy providing music for the Lenoir Rhyne as well as the local community. The first band, like the Oakview Orchestra, formed outside of Lenoir Rhyne's small music program. Director Alvin Lung, professor of chemistry and physics at Lenoir College, officially formed the band in 1921. The group consisted of 21 members and played one of their first concerts as the Lenoir Rhyne College Band, the Lenoir College Band in the spring of 1922. Through 1924, the band was primarily a marching band with its main purpose to provide entertainment at college functions. The last mention of the band was in 1924 before reappearing in 1935. The Lenoir Rhyne Band was reborn during the fall of 1935 by a student body push to bring more excitement to football games. Under the direction of Professor Kenneth B. Lee, the band began but was very small. 2 years later, in 1937, LR student Jay Hoffman took over leadership of the band. Hoffman turned the band into a well-oiled machine, rehearsing several times per week and convincing the college to purchase uniforms for the band. By 1938, the band was quite popular on campus and boasted 24 members and performed at football games and other events. Hoffman led the band in the first annual Lenoir Rhyne Band Spring Concert on March 31, 1939. Jay Hoffman remained the director until 1940. R. Walter Cartier became director and continued the traditions of the band. In September 1942, the band was given its first official rehearsal room. America became involved in World War II, and it became increasingly difficult for the band to operate. College athletics, as well as the band, were temporarily disbanded in 1945. Therefore, the LR band dropped out of existence once again. In 1947, under the direction of Dr. Robin F. Gatwood, the Lenoir Rhyne Band was reorganized yet again. The 25-member band began rehearsing in the summer to prepare for fall performances. LR spent approximately $2,000 on new instruments. Dr. Gatwood encouraged anyone to join the band, even those without any musical experience. By the fall of 1947, the band boasted 46 members, were measured for new uniforms, and were to be the centerpiece of the homecoming parade. This earned them the reputation and nickname among the LR students as the Miracle Band. Gatwood did not settle, and as soon as marching season was completed, he began working to create an even better concert band. This made Gatwood the first band director in LR history to make a concerted effort to run a varied, full year round band program. The band grew and made its first radio debut on March 3, 1948 on the local station WXKY. After concerts with the Hickory High School Band and more radio performances, Gatwood had established the Lenoir Rhyne Band as an integral part of both Lenoir-Rhyne and the Hickory community. And that was some 74 years ago. As the LR band grew and improved, the nickname the Miracle Band was replaced by the more fitting, the Snappy 60. In 1953, the Snappy 60 accompanied the LR football team to the Cigar Bowl in Tampa, Florida. Doug Sanders, the drum major, remembers the Cigar Bowl trip as a highlight of his band career at LR. During Gatwood's tenure, he formed not only the marching and concert bands, but also a jazz band nicknamed the Campus Cats and other chamber ensembles. Students fondly referred to Gatwood as Doc and sometimes Dad. He was much loved by the students and alumni. Dr. Gatwood was director of LR bands for 22 years before stepping down in 1969. He remained at LR in other administrative roles until his retirement in 1981 and passed away at his home here in Hickory in 1996. The next director of LR bands was Dr. Ralph Gabe Gabriel, who taught at LR along with his wife Libby. Like his predecessor, Dr. Gabriel was not content if the program was not growing and improving. The marching band was cut due to financial difficulties in 1975. There was a great outcry from students and the LR community, and it was restored a year later in the fall of 1976. Dr. Gabriel was instrumental in continuing the excellence of the marching band and the concert band, and he also founded the LR Brass Ensemble. Gabe, as his students affectionately called him, left his position at LR in 1983 after 17 years. During his years at LR, he inspired students and enriched the LR community in many ways. Dr. Ralph Gabriel passed away on February 13, 2019. In 1983, Dr. Joseph D. Seacrest arrived at Lenoir-Rhyne to fill the director of band's vacancy left by Dr. Gabriel's departure. During his time at LR, Dr. Seacrest continued as director of the marching band and the Lenoir-Rhyne Wind Ensemble. He developed recruiting practices such as school visits, hosting district events, and hosting the LR High School Honor Band. This community engagement increased band enrollment at LR by 300%. Dr. Seacrest left the position at LR only after 4 short years and currently resides in Rock Hill, South Carolina. Dr. Seacrest was succeeded by Mr. Robert T. Fleming. In 1987, leading both the marching band and wind ensemble, Mr. Fleming continued the traditions that had been previously established. During this time, Mr. Fleming employed the band director from Freedom High School, Mr. Ken Rudd, to direct the marching band, using high school students to fill out the numbers in the LR marching band. At the end of the 1991-92 academic year, the decision was made to end the marching band. Lack of funding and fading LR student interest resulted in the LR marching band appearing to be finished for good, or so it would seem. Robert Fleming retired from LR in 1992 and passed away in 1998 at the young age of 66. The fifth tenured director of bands in Lenoir-Rhyne's history was Dr. Daniel Wayne Kaiser. He began in August of 1992. Dr. Kaiser made the wind ensemble a year-long course and continued the practice of augmenting the band with community members. In 1996, the LR Pep Band was formed to bring a live musical presence back to the football games. The Pep Band was led by numerous directors through the years. Dr. Kaiser founded and directed the Pep Band through the fall of 2000. After that, the group was led by Rick Klein, Chris Negrelli, and David Wortman. Dr. Kaiser was elevated to chair of the School of Fine Arts in 2000 and to the position of Dean of Arts and Sciences in 2008, a position he held until his recent retirement. As Dr. Kaiser continued to develop the concert program and having a student-only band, the wind ensemble became a possibility. Students continued to combine with community members in the LR Concert Band, which eventually was named the LR Wind Symphony. Having the wind ensemble and wind symphony is the same format we use today. During the 2014-15 school year, a decision was made to restart again the Lenoran Marching Band after a 23-year absence. Combining the needs and desires of music and athletic programs, the outcry from the game attendees, and the work of Neil McGahey and Dan Kaiser, the possibility of the new marching band became a reality. In the fall of 2015, Neil S. Underwood, Lincoln County High School band director for a combined 32 years, was hired to relaunch the LR Marching Band. During the fall of 2015, Underwood directed the LR Pep Band and spent the remainder of the year assisting Dr. Kaiser with a wind symphony, teaching music education courses, traveling the state recruiting new students, and purchasing and setting up equipment for the newly nicknamed Spirit of LR Marching Band. On Saturday, September the 3rd, 2016, the 52-member Spirit of LR Marching Band took the field at LR's first home game. It was a spectacular evening with a very receptive and appreciative audience. The Spirit performed at all home games, traveled to Newton Conover at the high school to perform at the Southeastern Classic Band competition, and marched in downtown Charlotte in the Navant Health Thanksgiving Day Parade, which was regionally televised. The Spirit of LR grew to 75 members in 2017 and to 88 members in 2018, each fall performing in exhibitions at local high school band competitions. In 2018, the band traveled to Atlantic Beach in Havelock High School to perform as the exhibition band at the Crystal Coast Classic Band Competition. In addition to a wonderful performance, band members visited the North Carolina Aquarium and took a pretty chilly splash in the cold Atlantic. In the fall of 2019, the Spirit had grown to 104 members, selected to march in the 2020 National Cherry Blossom Parade in Washington, D.C. Plans were being made for the 100-member band to travel to our nation's capital. Meanwhile, from 2015 through 2019, the instrumental side of the LR music program grew tremendously. The Wind Symphony boasted approximately 100 members, with over 50% being LR students. Dr. Kaiser and Mr. Underwood restarted the student-only wind ensemble, and on March the 25th, 2019, the wind ensemble performed the first student conductor concert, giving the unique opportunity for music education students to rehearse and conduct a band prior to their student teaching experience. In November 2019, the Wind Symphony, with approximately 100 members, was invited to perform at the North Carolina Music Educators Conference in Winston-Salem. The concert was a huge success and met with rave reviews from band directors from around North Carolina. LR recruiting efforts received a huge boost from this performance, and I heard from many. In mid-March 2020, oh my, everything came to a halt to a worldwide pandemic known as COVID-19. The Spirit of LR trip to Washington was canceled, along with the a cappella choir and brass ensemble's trip to New York City. Concerts for wind symphony, jazz, and other ensembles were canceled. Students were sent home what would thought to have been 2 weeks, did not return until the fall semester. Returning to campus in August 2020, wearing masks, COVID testing, socially distant rehearsals, bell covers on brass instruments, making music was very different. And due to LR's proactive stance and the COVID task force guidance, LR was one of the very few college bands permitted to rehearse concert and marching band during the 2020-21 school year. Community members were not allowed on campus, therefore only the wind ensemble was active. Fall performances of the wind ensemble and marching band were shared on YouTube as well as Facebook. On April the 21st, 2021, the LR Wind Ensemble presented a long concert, which was the first live event on campus that entire year. And I can say off script, the music and our vocal choir program did as well as anyone in working with our students through the COVID period. This current academic year, 2021-22, with fully vaccinated students and staff, things have returned as close to normal as possible. Indoor masks were required until recently. The Wind Symphony and the Wind Ensemble gave two concerts in the fall, and the Spirit of LR marched again at all home games and performed for two exhibitions, as well as the Hickory Christmas Parade. Dr. Dan Kaiser retired from Lenoir-Rhyne in 2021, but his leadership of our bands and all of the fine arts programs will be evident for years to come. The Wind Ensemble and the Wind Symphony have since been under the direction of Christopher Negrelli and Neil Underwood. And a little off script on a personal note, I want to thank all the members of our music faculty, staff, and our students who've worked so hard to make our music performance special at LR. They bring so much spirit, so much culture, so much joy to our campus and our community at large. And I wanted to let you know publicly this evening that our Lenoir-Rhyne University Board of Trustees voted last week to unanimously present the University Trustee Award, the highest award we would give to a faculty or staff for outstanding service to Dan Kaiser, the highest award we can bestow, and he will receive this at the commencement ceremony in a couple of weeks. Thank you very much.
Thank you. Dr. Daniel Wayne Kaiser became the fifth director of bands at Lenoir Rhyne University in August of 1992, earning a Bachelor of Music in Music Education and a Master's of Music in Trumpet Performance from Southern Illinois University at Carbondale. He went on to earn a Doctorate in Musical Arts and Trumpet Performance and Literature from the University of Illinois. Prior to his appointment at Lenoir Rhyne, Dr. Kaiser served on the faculty of North Dakota State University at Fargo from 1985 to 1992. During his tenure, the music program has made great strides in content and enrollment, restructuring the Wind Symphony to a year-round course while continuing to augment the band with community members. The band grew to over 100 members pre-pandemic. In 2010, the Wind Ensemble was formed as a smaller student-only ensemble. He also led the program through the reestablishment of the widely acclaimed Spirit of Lenoir Rhyne Marching Band and the continuance of our sacred music program while upholding our strong choral traditions. Dr. Kaiser was elevated to the chair of the School of Fine Arts in 2000 and promoted to the Dean of the College of Arts and Sciences in 2008. He was honored by students in 2012 with a dedication of the Hakawa, awarded a Roediger Distinguished Professor Award in 2019, and upon his retirement in 2021, the status of Professor Emeritus. He committed to teaching, he felt compelled to be an active professional musician, performing at the yearly International Trumpet Guild Convention with the Hickory Choral Society, as a contract musician with the Western Piedmont Symphony, and as a player and arranger for the Unifor Brass Ensemble. His hymn descants for trumpet were published by Collin Music of New York and are widely used. In addition to music, Dr. Kaiser has become an avid and exhibited photographer whose photos of student musicians can be seen throughout the lobby of Monty Music. He also enjoys communicating people from across the globe as a ham radio operator. Retirement has allowed him to have more time to spend with the trumpet at his home church, his hobbies, and with his granddaughter, Kenna. And now, ladies and gentlemen, please welcome to the stage our own conductor emeritus, mentor to students and faculty alike, our dear friend, Dr. Daniel Kaiser.
There I am. Howdy. So just to take a moment to pause, because as a music program, we would really like to take a moment to recognize all of the particular legacy of Dr. Daniel Kaiser in leading the program. His persistence, his personal vision, and his leadership as the director of bands has sought to remake not just the instrumental program, but the music program as a whole. And what you really see throughout the program is really that persistence coming to fruition, including, you know, down to this beautiful hall, that shell back there, that really helps a ton, to the marching band, and of course, to this magnificent wind symphony. So, to that end, the music program has a commemorative plaque for Dr. Daniel Kaiser, and it reads as such, well, thank you, in recognition and appreciation for your years of service, dedication, and love to the Lenore Rhine music program and to the bands of Lenore Rhine. This is presented to you as a memento. Thank you. Congratulations.